They are great. The plans I have for you, you know, they are marvelous. They are too much. He said to give you an expected end. You know what? By the time he discovered what God had for him, even though the Bible says he was taller, a shoulder taller than anyone in the land of Israel, but he saw himself as nobody. He saw himself as nothing. But God said, he said, when you were little, were you not made? Wow. And now I tell you something, there is something about the enemies of his life that didn't allow him to prevail. We are going to look at it today, because as we are looking at the help from the Lord that will help us to overcome the enemies of life, if you are able to overcome these enemies of life, I tell you, the devil can't do nothing in your life.
Hallelujah.
Because you are breaking those things. You are breaking the link he uses to sponsor into your life. You are disconnecting those things like an extension of his life. And once those things are dealt with, the enemy will be handicapped over your destiny. Our plan and our desire and our heart cry is that as this week is coming to an end, whatever be the enemies of your own life, you will be able to not only overcome them, you will be able to destroy them, and you will be able to go forward to accomplish what God has for you. I want to read the book of 1 Samuel chapter 13, verse 13. It says, "And Samuel said to Saul, thou hast done foolishly. Thou hast not kept the commandments of the Lord thy God, which he commanded thee. For now would the Lord have established thy kingdom upon Israel forever." We saw how the enemy of his life cut him short for what God had in plan to do in him. We saw that this enemy we saw in him is the enemy of foolishness. Now, he didn't call it foolishness, but that was what the servant of God clearly told him. If you read your Bible very well, I would like you to read that place. 1 Samuel chapter 13, read the whole chapter. You will see that before then, he was thinking he was right. He said, yes, I have fulfilled the word the Lord has given me. I have done this, I have done this, I have done that. God told him, you have done foolishly. By the time the servant of God explained the consequences of what he did. You know, sometimes we need the light of the word of God for you to see clearly what you are doing that is not right. He said, you have done foolishly. I pray for you, you will not do foolishly. And in case you have done foolishly in any way, I trust the Lord that from now there will be a return. So that, do you know why the word is for him to repent. I want to show you another place in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 24. He said, and Saul said unto Samuel, I have sinned. That's another scenario now. This another scenario. Two chapters has gone and years have gone. Now look at what he said. I have done foolishly, for I have sinned. He said, Saul said to Samuel, I have sinned, for I have transgressed the commandment of the Lord and thy words. Why? Because I feared the people and obeyed their voice. That is another enemy of life. He had fear for what people would say. He had fear for what, you know, he preferred the fact, let it not be that these people, because of the fear he has for the people, he said, for because I feared the people and I obeyed their voice. How can you live a life that God sent you to do on earth and you are having the fear of men above the fear of God? If Saul had had the fear of God, he could have stood in the counsel of God and the enemy would not cut short. We saw how God rejected him. There are people whom God has sent to fulfill destinies on earth, but because they are not able to see the counsel of God and receive help from God against the enemies of life, we see them going forward in their foolishness. But our prayer for you hearing us today is that every enemy of life displayed in several ways. We saw the fear of men. We saw the fear of men. We saw foolishness. We saw how the man said he listened to the voice of the people. I don't know who you are listening to. Maybe the voice of a friend, the voice of a colleague that is speaking contradictory to the counsel of God. He said, I've not listened to the voice of the servant of God, that is Prophet Samuel. I've not listened to the voice of the Lord, because he feared the people and obeyed their voice. I don't know. This is a very, very, you know, the enemy that brought him down. He's the enemy. The other one that he did foolishly, but he went ahead to graduate from foolishness to have fear for men. I pray for you that whatever fear you have for men that made you not to fear the counsel of God shall be destroyed today. You are going to trust God to give you his help so that you can look at the things that you used to do before and say, no more. I may have obeyed my father or my mother, and that counsel is against the counsel of the word of God, and that right now I begin to obey God. I stand in the counsel of God so that I will be able to achieve what God wants me to achieve in life. In the name of Jesus, you are going to trust God for that grace.
Hallelujah.
You are going to trust God for that grace.
In the name of Jesus. Yes.
Saul, in the eyes of men, was doing well. The Bible said he returned from the Amalek. He killed all of them, you know, but they spared some things that God told them not to spare. I don't know what you are sparing in your life. I don't know what, maybe a little lie here, maybe a little that lie there. Maybe fear for men like we just saw. Maybe obeying the voice of men. I don't know what it is that makes you to do foolishly. You can return and receive help from God, because we said already that what men call success is not what God calls success in the final analysis. It is God's intention for you to see from the perspective, so that what he sent you on earth to do, you will accomplish it. We pray that whatever enemies, you know, this enemy is a very subtle one. Just like we saw in the life of David. It was a subtle enemy. You know, David could have said, when the brother confronted him, anyway, he's my elder brother. He's more experienced than me. He's older than me. He has been an army officer. And I'm just a boy who is taking care of sheep. Maybe what I'm thinking is not right. No, he was able to perceive. And then he didn't allow what his brother was telling him to stop him. These are enemies. Do you know what? If you are able to locate these enemies, then receive help from God to relegate them and make them not to have any effect on me over your life, I tell you that no devil can stop your destiny. Tell you that you'll be able to accomplish, and I pray for you like David, who was able to conquer all of those things and stood and came back with the head of that Goliath. You'll be able to conquer every giant in your life.